So Gita Mataji asked another question about desires. Krishna is saying that you have to control your desires. It is not easy to control desires when we are living in this beautiful world. I am not that strong. What practical tip can you give today so that we can work on it?
Can you repeat that question again, Prabhu?
So she is asking for practical tips to control the desires, because it is not so easy to control the desires.
The practical tips, actually studying, that's what this, we need to somehow get this knowledge. That's the main thing, this Bhagavad Gita knowledge. So then we will automatically ourselves get that love towards Krishna. That's going to come. So then automatically your desires will be only to please Krishna. So we cannot control the desires, the material desires, by force. That is not even the right way to do it. In the second chapter, Krishna is saying that, in the sloka number 56 or 57, Krishna is saying that, Visaya vinivartante niraharasya deginaga rasavarjam rasopyasya param drishtva nivartate. That's what Krishna is saying there. So Visaya vinivartante means it is possible to control our desires by force, but that is not the right way to do. So that's what Krishna is saying there. That's not the right way to do in the 59th sloka. So by experiencing a higher taste, you will automatically give up the lower taste. So first of all, we should experience Krishna consciousness by serving Krishna. So though the embodied soul may be restricted from sense enjoyment, the taste for sense object remains, but ceasing such engagements by experiencing a higher taste is fixed in consciousness. So we need to first experience the higher taste. So the higher taste is Krishna consciousness. So this, with the Bhagavad Gita knowledge, when you start serving Krishna, when you start spreading this message, when you make many devotees, when you tell everyone about only Bhagavad Gita, all the time you talk only about Bhagavad Gita only. So that way, when you find enjoyment in that service, that remembering Krishna, doing everything for Krishna, talking about Krishna, everything. So Krishna is saying that machitta madgata prana bodhayantaga parasparam kadayantascha mam nityam tushyanti cha ramanti cha. So my devotees always thinking about me, are dedicating their lives unto me, so conversing only about me with one another, they derive great satisfaction and bliss. So if you are able to find that kind of happiness and satisfaction, then you will automatically give up the lower taste. So that is the way to control our senses. Not by force, it is not possible. So that's why this Bhagavad Gita knowledge is very important. Serving Krishna is very important. Once we get a taste here, once we enjoy this, once we are able to enjoy this unlimited happiness, so then we will automatically give up the lower taste. Hare Krishna. You understand, Mataji, now? Hare Krishna.
Very well explained. Thanks, Guruji. But one of the things you always say is, serving Krishna is to, you know, talk about Krishna, which I think about Krishna all the time, but I don't have knowledge like how you have, because you have answer to every question. If my own kids ask me, I don't have, all the knowledge. So I can't even think about telling other people about Gita if I myself have, I don't know anything yet, because I'm reading now. I'm trying to do it. But then I'm not like you, how you can tell this log, and I can't do that. So how can I serve Krishna?
Everyone can do it, Mataji, because we don't need to know the complete knowledge to start serving. Even if one or two slokas, if you know, so then you can tell others. You can tell. Then slowly, slowly, that way you will gain. In fact, I'll just tell you how I remember so many slokas. When I started studying Bhagavad Gita, especially when I was doing my PhD in IIT Madras. So if I know one sloka that day, anyone I meet, I tell them that sloka. Somehow connect with something and you tell. So that way, many times you repeat that sloka, tell others, then automatically you will remember. So that was possible in a lifestyle where you will meet with so many friends in a student, as a student, that was very much possible. So, but now you can just yourself study, and any other friends or anyone who are willing to listen, or your your relatives or your family members or anyone, they can listen to you. Just one sloka you study and tell them. So that way, slowly you'll know more and more knowledge. You'll get this knowledge. And another thing is that we are studying Bhagavad Gita in Zoom every day. Many devotees are joining. We can just find a way to spread this information that we are studying. There are many devotees out in the world. They don't know that we are doing this. If they know it, they will join. There are many sincere devotees are there. There is no doubt about it. So now you can also think, you means all of us should think about how we can let everybody to know that we are studying Bhagavad Gita every day. Because simply by coming here, they can study. So that way, it is not that we individually have to go and teach this Bhagavad Gita, but if we are able to put efforts to spread this message that others know about this. So then, for example, Timir Prabhu was constantly trying to put it in Facebook, media, all those things. So because of that, now we have so many devotees have joined. So like that, all of us, everyone can think about that and plan all those things. So that is the way we can serve Krishna by bringing more devotees together. You understand that, Mataji?
Yes, thank you, Guruji. That's very nice. I'm going to share it with my friends on Facebook as well. I'll ask to get the Facebook. Thank you so much.
What happens, Mataji, if you start doing it, what is going to happen? You will have get some more friends joining whom you know already. So then your team will develop. So when you have such team develops, then as a team, you can start discussing how we can do all those things. See, this is all Krishna has got plans. If we are willing to, if we desire to serve Krishna, then Krishna will plan all these things will happen. So that way we will have teams everywhere, in each and every city, everywhere we will have teams of devotees. Our goal is straightforward, study Bhagavad Gita. That's it. Spread Bhagavad Gita. That's it. So since we are only doing this, if we do this service to Krishna, we will keep ourselves engaged in this service. Then at one point of time, when you keep doing it, you will experience so much satisfaction, actually. When you make so many devotees, when you bring so many devotees, you are serving Krishna, you will feel very much satisfied. And that satisfaction, because of such satisfaction, it will keep us very busy. You will not have any time to do anything, material things, actually. So that way Krishna will engage us. It will happen. Hare Krishna.